Yes. Good morning, my lovely students. How are you all? I hope everyone is good. So today we are going to continue our lesson number 2. The name of this lesson is subject and predicate. So yesterday we studied about what is subject and what is predicate. So today we will do the exercise of this chapter. So before start the exercise, I am sharing a video of subject and predicate for better understanding. Please have a look.
Subject and predicate. A complete sentence has two parts, a subject and a predicate. For example, people from all nations go to see the Eiffel Tower.
In this sentence,
people from all nations
is the naming part, also called the subject. The subject tells whom or what the sentence is about.
The subject is either a noun or a noun phrase.
All the words in the subject are together called the complete subject.
The other part of the sentence, that is, go to see the Eiffel Tower, is the telling part, also called the predicate. The predicate tells something about the subject. It begins with a verb. All the words in the predicate are together called the complete predicate.
Yes, student. So this is a chapter number 2, subject and predicates. We already discussed about the subject and predicate. So let's start from the example. So what is the subject and what is the predicate in the sentence? So let's start. Number A, dekhiye. Look at the pictures and then read the following sentences. Okay. Number 1, Peter runs fast. Number 2, Ashok is reading. And number 3 is here, horses eat grasses. Okay, and number 4th is here, as the birds fly in the sky. Okay, students, so in this chapter, you know that, so how will we understand what is the subject? So, and number 5th is here, girls are eating ice cream. So, in the number 1 sentence, you know very well, we speak about Peter. So, firstly, you know that in the subject, I told you about the subject that how we identify the subject. कैसे हम आइडेंटिफाई करते हैं देखिए सब्जेक्ट इज हियर द पर्सन और थिंग वी स्पीक अबाउट इज कॉल्ड सब्जेक्ट जिस भी पर्सन या थिंग के बारे में हम बात करते हैं वो क्या कहलाता है सब्जेक्ट नंबर सेकंड द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ अ सेंटेंस इज द नाउन दैट इज डूइंग और बीइंग समथिंग एंड नंबर थर्ड इज हियर इट टेल्स हु और व्हाट द सेंटेंस इज अबाउट ये हमको बताता है कि सब्जेक्ट किसके बारे में है सो इन द फाइव सेंटेंसेस यू नोटिस दैट इन द फर्स्ट sentence we speak about Peter in the second sentence we speak about Ashok in the third sentence we speak about horses eat grasses eh? In the fourth sentence we speak about birds and in the fifth sentence we speak about girls okay students so in a sentence the person or thing we speak about is called the subject जब भी हम किसी पर्सन या थिंग के बारे में बात करते हैं वो क्या कहलाता है सब्जेक्ट कहलाता है यू नोटिस दैट इन द नंबर 1 सेंटेंस पीटर रन्स फास्ट ओके पीटर रन्स फास्ट तो वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट पीटर हम किसकी बात कर रहे हैं पीटर की बात कर रहे हैं कि हु रन्स फास्ट यस वी गेट आवर आंसर पीटर रन्स फास्ट पीटर इज आवर सब्जेक्ट तो पीटर क्या है बच्चों हमारा सब्जेक्ट है सो इन द लास्ट क्लास यू notice that we have to clear that the you have to remember 3 points yes the person or thing we speak about is called subject second thing you must remember that noun is that the sentence is the noun sentence mein noun bhi ho sakta hai pronoun bhi ho sakta hai okay is doing or being something ki hum kya kar rahe hai ki noun kuch kar raha hai so peter run fast to peter kya kar raha hai tez dauda runs fast to peter ka jo kaam hai kisne kiya yes jo tez dauda hoga kaun dauda peter dauda so we get our answer subject. Now number third, you must remember that it tells who or what the sentence is about. ये हमको बताता है कि sentence किसके बारे में है. So Peter runs fast. So who runs fast? So we get our answer. Peter runs fast. So in this sentence, we are talking about a Peter. So Peter is our subject. So children, I hope you have to clear the identification of subject. In the number second sentence, Ashok is reading. So who is reading, student? Yes, Ashok is reading, and we are talking about the Ashok in this sentence. The Ashok is here as a subject. In the number third sentence, horses eat grass. So who eat grass? Yes, we get our answer. Horses eat grass. अब देखिए जो doing कर रहा है, जो action word, action जो verb हो रही है, जो action जो words है, वो काम कौन कर रहा है? वो काम horses कर रहे हैं. So we get our subject. So this is our subject is here, horses. In the fourth number sentence, birds fly in the sky. Now you notice that a fly in the sky, we get our answer, birds. Now after that, the birds क्या कर रहे हैं? आकाश में उड़ रहे हैं. तो हमको second number कौन सी ये clear हो रहा है कि noun that is doing something. Noun क्या है बच्चों इसमें? Birds noun है. और वो क्या कर रहे हैं? Fly in the sky, वो आकाश में उड़ते हैं. तो birds fly in the sky. तो birds का काम क्या हो रहा है? Action क्या हो रहा है? Fly करना. जो action करने वाला कौन है? Birds है. तो we get an answer, we get a subject. Birds is here in this sentence. Next sentence, girls are eating ice cream. So who are eating ice cream? Yes, we get our answer. Girls are eating ice cream. When we raise a question, what or whom? So who are eating ice cream? Girls are eating ice cream. Now second is, what the girls are doing? Girls kya kar rahi hai? Are eating ice cream. So eating is here, you notice, as a action word. Khana, खा रही है. तो action कौन कर रहा है? हमको इसी से भी पता चलेगा कि action कौन कर रहा है. Action girls कर रही है. So in the same manner, you notice that the girls are eating ice cream. The girls, we are talking about the girls in this sentence. So girls is here as a subject. Yes, student. Now next is here. Now student, find out what is said about the subject in each of the above sentence. In the first sentence, we say about the subject Peter, that he runs fast. We already discussed about this, about the subject that Peter. हम किसके बारे में बात कर रहे हैं? Peter के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं. The number one sentence में Peter runs fast. In the second sentence, we say about the Ashok, that is, he is reading. So we are talking about the Ashok. Who is reading? Ashok is reading. So Ashok is here as a subject. In the number third sentence, we say about the subject horses, that they eat grasses. So horses is here in the number third sentence. Horses is here a subject. Okay, student. Now in the sentence number four, we say about the subject birds fly in the sky. So subject is here as a bird. So birds fly in the sky. Now in the sentence number fifth, we say about the subject. In the sentence number fifth, jo sentence kya hai? Girls are eating ice cream. Who are eating ice cream? Girls. Now our subject is here, girls. So student, this is clear to you that the subject is here. You notice that as a Peter, Ashok, horses, birds, and girls. Clear, student? Now let's start the what is a predicate. So what is said about the subject is called predicate, जिसको हम क्या बोलते हैं? विधेय पाठ. ओके, सो जिसके बारे में बात कही जा रही है वो क्या कहलाता है? हमारा predicate पार्ट. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट नंबर वन सेंटेंस, पीटर रन्स फास्ट. सो पीटर तो हमको समझ में आ गया कि हमारा सब्जेक्ट है, लेकिन पीटर के बारे में क्या बताया गया? पीटर रन्स फास्ट. तो पीटर क्या कर रहा है? रन कर रहा है फास्ट, मतलब तेज दौड़ रहा है. तो तेज दौड़ता है. सो रन फास्ट इज अ predicate part. You notice two things about the predicate. So you must remember the predicate part contains verb. Predicate part mein verb hoti hai. Now second thing you must remember that the predicate part contains all the telling part. Jo predicate part hota hai wahi hamara kya hota hai? Telling part. To Peter ke bare mein kaha ja raha hai ki Peter runs fast. So here we get the answer, we get the predicate. Okay students, clear? Now let's start the E. From the above, it is clear that every sentence must have two parts. आपको clear हो गया होगा कि प्रत्येक sentence, every complete sentence, we must say that every complete sentence must have two parts. First is subject and second is predicate. Subject को हम हिंदी में क्या बोलते हैं? कर्ता, जो काम करता है. And predicate part जिसको हम विधेय बोलते हैं, means हमारा जो naming part है. So you can draw note down here. Subject is our naming part and predicate is our telling part. Clear, student? So now move on the next phase. Yes. So student, in the following sentences are divided into subject and predicate. You notice the 10 sentences is here. India is a great country. The workmen were lazy. He died for his country. This horse is beautiful. Some boys were flying kites. Number 6, his axe fell into the water. Number 7, a blind man cannot see. Number 8, the wind is blowing. Number 9 is here, the poor boy began to weep. And number 10, can you speak English? Okay, student. So we have to identify the subject and predicate in the sentences. So let's start number 1 sentence. India is a great country. Now let's start from the identification of subject. So we are talking about in this sentence, we are talking about the India. So India is our subject and telling part is here, जिसके बारे में बताया गया है क्या है, India is a great country. Number 2nd sentence, the workmen were lazy. So workmen, have you noticed that workmen, this is a plural. यहाँ पर क्या है, man जब भी होता है तो क्या होता है, वो plural form होता है, और man होता तो singular होता. You notice that? Okay, workmen, so here we use as a verb, word, not was. Okay, so if the subject is plural, so where we use as a plural verb, as a we use verb. Clear? The workmen were lazy. So we are talking about in the sentence the workman. The workman is a subject and telling part is here, were lazy. So this is our predicate part. Clear? Number 3rd sentence, he died for his country. Yes, who died for his country? Yes, he. He is here as a pronoun. He kya hai bachcho yahan pe? As a pronoun hai. Okay, so aapko samajh mein aa gaya, he is here, our subject. And the telling part is here, died for his country. Wo apne desh ke liye mar gaya. So here you notice that he died for his country. This is our predicate part. Number 4th sentence is here, this house is beautiful. Okay, so we are talking about the house. The house is here as a subject. Yes, this house. Do you notice that? आपने कई बार स्टूडेंट्स आप होते हैं कि आप हाउस पे ही अंडरलाइन करेंगे, आप दिस या डेट हेज जो भी आएगा उसको अंडरलाइन नहीं करते आप. यू नोटिस, बट यू हैव टू रिमेम्बर दैट दिस हाउस इज अ सब्जेक्ट पार्ट एंड इस ब्यूटीफुल हाउस के बारे में बताया गया है. उसका जो हमारा जो टेलिंग पार्ट है वो बता रहे हैं कि हाउस कैसा है, बहुत ही सुंदर है. सो दिस इज अ प्रेडिकेट. नंबर 5th सेंटेंस, some boys were flying kites. So firstly you identify that we are talking about in this sentence some boys. So some boys were flying kites. So some boys are subject and were flying kites are predicate part. Number 6th sentence, his axe fell into the water. So his axe, we are talking about the his axe. Okay, so this is our subject and telling part is here, fell into the water. This is our predicate part. Number 7th sentence, a blind man cannot see. Okay, so blind man dekh nahi sakta hai. So blind man is here as a subject and cannot see our predicate means telling part. Number 8th sentence, the wind is blowing. Hawa beh rahi hai. So we are talking about kiske baare mein baat chal rahi sentence mein? Wind ke baare mein. So wind is here as a subject. Now we are talking about the predicate part. The predicate part is blowing. Yes, predicate also must contain a verb and the together verb is here as a predicate. Number 9th sentence, the poor boy began to weep. The poor boy, we are talking about in this sentence, poor boy. Who began to weep? Poor boy. So this is our subject. And lastly, starting from the verb, this is our predicate part. Poor boy ke baare mein kya bataya ja raha hai? Telling part kya hai? Began to weep. Usne रोना शुरू किया. सो हियर दिस इज आवर प्रेडिकेट पार्ट. नंबर 10 इज हियर, यू कैन स्पीक इंग्लिश. बट आवर सेंटेंस इज हियर, यू नोटिस आवर सेंटेंस इज हियर, कैन यू स्पीक इंग्लिश. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन फॉर्म. सो यू कैन यू ऑल्सो फाइंड आउट दिस सब्जेक्ट इन दिस सेंटेंस. तो आपने नोटिस किया होगा कि नहीं मैम, जो स्टार्टिंग होता है वही हमारा सब्जेक्ट है और स्टार्टिंग हो रहा है हमारा कैन से. सो क्या हमारा जो सब्जेक्ट कैन होगा? नो. सो यू नोटिस अबाउट द सब्जेक्ट इन दिस सेंटेंस. द सब्जेक्ट इज हियर यू. You cannot speak English. Can is your modal verb you use here. You cannot is, you can speak English. Tum English bol sakte ho. But the question is here, can you speak English? Kya tum English bol sakte ho? But we only find out the subject and predicate. So you is here as a subject and can speak English is our predicate part. Kya speak English bol sakte hain? Ye hamara kaun sa part hai? Hamara predicate part hai. So student, this is clear to you? So how can we identify the subject and predicate? Okay, now next is here. Students, sometimes the subject is understood or left out. कई बार क्या होता है कि जो हमारा जो सब्जेक्ट होता है वो अंडरस्टूड, मतलब हमको पहले ही समझ रहा होता है कि हाँ यू इसके अंदर क्या होगा, अंडरस्टूड हमको समझ गया है ना. और लेफ्ट आउट, कई बार उसको लेफ्ट आउट मीन्स कई बार हम उसको राइट भी नहीं करते, हम स्पीक भी नहीं करते. ओके, सो इन द फॉलोइंग सेंटेंसेस द सब्जेक्ट यू इज लेफ्ट आउट. जो ये जो फॉलोइंग सेंटेंसेस दे रहे हैं, जो नीचे सेंटेंस दिए गए हैं, उसमें लेफ्ट क्या है? लेफ्ट आउट किया गया. नंबर वन सेंटेंस, come in, which means really means, इसका मतलब क्या है? You come in. So you को क्या किया? Left out किया. You क्या है? Understood है कि आपको समझ में आ गया कि you क्या है यहाँ पर. Already you know. Also in the class, when we in the class, so we always teacher said that please come in, go out, sit down, stand up. Okay, so this is a command form. So you is understandable. Okay, यहाँ पर you क्या understandable है. So when we speak a sentence, we omitted it you. When we write a sentence, we also omitted you. Okay, this is only understood. Number second sentence, you go out. Okay, so really means you go out. Sit down means you sit down. Stand up means you stand up. Number fifth, run. Really means you run. And number six, stop. Really means you stop. Okay, student? So in all these sentences, the word you, which is left out, is the subject. In सभी sentences में जो you है, left out कर रखा है, उनको हटाया गया है, is the subject. वो क्या है इसमें? Subject है. Okay, student? So clear this exercise? Okay. Now let's start the exercise of this chapter. So students, firstly the exercise number one, read each sentence, write a subject for it. आपको क्या करना है? सबसे पहले sentence को read करना है और आपको अब क्या करना है? Subject को write down करना है. Okay. So now you can see the image, a bucket of apples. Yes. Now, number one, dash are my favorite fruit. You can notice the apples. Okay, so here we write down the apples. Okay, our subject is here, apples. A-P-P-L-E-S. Clear, student? Okay. Yes. The second sentence, dash is the tallest building in Delhi. So you can see the image. This is the clue is given here, you can see. So this is a Qutub Minar. Okay, students, so you have to write here the Qutub Minar. The Qutub Minar. Qutub Minar is the tallest building in Delhi. Okay, number third sentence, dash revolves around the sun. ये तो आपको पता ही होगा, you can see. ये this image, yes, the earth. The answer is, the earth is our subject. So the earth revolves around the sun. Clear? Number fourth sentence, dash can be played on ice also. अब देखिए, ice हम बात कर रहे हैं, dash can be played on ice also. You can see the image. So this is given a clue दे रखा है. So answer is here, hockey. Clear? Number fifth sentence, dash is called the father of the nation. You can see the image. Yes, I know, everybody know about this. Yes, Mahatma Gandhi, MAHATMA, Mahatma GANDHI, Mahatma Gandhi, the father, is called the father of the nation. Clear, student? Okay, number six sentence is here. Dash is our national animal. So you can see the image. Yes, tiger is our national animal. Clear? Okay. Number seven sentence is here. Dash of India is also called the tricolor. अब आपको पता है tricolor किसमें होता है? आपको पता है? The national flag. T-H-E, the national. Write down the spelling. N-A-T-I-O-N-A-L. National. F-L-A-G. Flag. Okay. The national flag. Is a national flag of India is also called the tricolor. Clear, student? Number eight sentence, dash sheds its skin. You can see the image. Yes, answer is here. You notice the snake. Yes, snake. You can write here S-N-A-K-E. Snake. Clear? Now, so this is exercise number one. So let's start the exercise number two. The exercise number two is here. Add predicates to the following subjects. अभी हमने जो exercise number one है उसमें हमने subject fill किए हैं. अब हमको क्या करना है कि predicates को हमको क्या करना है fill करना है. So let's start number one sentence. In winter dash. So in winter you can write the predicate here. In winter children make a snowman. Clear? In winter, children make a snowman. You can see the image of a snowman here. Okay, the clues are also given here. Now, in the number two sentence, in summer, we dash. In summer, we go to a hill station. Okay, in summer, we go to a hill station. Clear? This is a predicate part. Okay, number third sentence, my favorite is sports. आपका favorite sports क्या है? आप कुछ भी लिख सकते हैं. Favorite sports, आपका जो भी होगा, football है, volleyball है ना? So here you can see the image of that. So here we write as my favorite sport is cricket. Now, number fourth sentence, aeroplanes. डैश तो एरोप्लेन्स अब आपको प्रेडिकेट अब फिल करना है. ओके, यू कैन सी द इमेज ऑफ एरोप्लेन्स. तो एरोप्लेन्स फ्लाई हाई इन द स्काई. ओके, क्लियर? एरोप्लेन्स फ्लाई हाई इन द स्काई. नंबर फिफ्थ सेंटेंस, द पोस्टमैन. ओके, तो पोस्टमैन क्या करता है आपको पता होगा. यस, द पोस्टमैन ब्रिंग्स अ लेटर and letters and parcels. Clear, student? So you must remember that the first letter should start with the capital letter and end with the full stop. यहाँ पर जो first letter है वो start किस होगा capital letter. तो first letter तो क्या है, देखिए in this sentence the postman. तो T क्या होना चाहिए, capital होना चाहिए और end किस होना चाहिए, full stop से. Clear, student? Yes. Synthesis sentence, the trees. Okay, the trees are tall and strong. Yes, student, the trees are tall and strong. Okay, so now move on the next page, student. Yes, in the number seven sentence, a large cloud. Now, this way, you can see the image also, a large cloud. So, in the large cloud, you write the predicate part here. In the large cloud, watch the match. W-A-T-C-H-E-D, watch the match. M-A-T-C-H. Okay, student, clear? Now, number eight sentence, stars, are they clear? Stars shine at night. Okay, the stars shine at night. So, this is our second exercise. Okay, student, so you have to fill the predicate part. Okay, now let's start the exercise number third. So, this exercise is related to subject and predicate. So, you have to remember that the three points that you know that you have to match the particular the subject. So, don't be forget to that the postman gather honey from the flower. So, you have to use your ability, you have to use your skills. So, firstly, you have to understand the sentences and then after that, you have to match the word. Now, number one is here, as we also given, the number one, the postman brings a letter. So, clear that the aeroplane is not matching, because it brings a letter. Yes, the postman brings us a letter. Now, number second sentence, an aeroplane. Now, second sentence, we have to match aeroplane. इसके अंदर क्या एरोप्लेन से मैच करेंगे हम इसे जी से. एरोप्लेन फ्लाइज वेरी फास्ट. तो हियर यू नोटिस हियर वी राइट एज अ सेकंड जी. एरोप्लेन फ्लाइज वेरी फास्ट. नंबर थर्ड सेंटेंस, अ पुलिसमैन. पुलिसमैन कैचेस थीव्स. यस, एंड द थर्ड सेंटेंस मैच टू जे. क्लियर? एंड नंबर फोर्थ सेंटेंस, द बुचर. यस, नंबर फोर्थ सेंटेंस मैच टू आई. सेल्स मीट. ओके, ओके. नंबर फिफ्थ सेंटेंस इज हियर, द ट्रेन. द ट्रेन इज हियर, सो यू हैव टू मैच द थी.
runs on grey. Okay. Okay, number six sentence, bees get the so no suitable, the predicate part is here, H, gather honey from flowers. Okay, so you have to write G here. Okay, now number seven sentence, the maid servant, so you have to match E, washes the dishes and plates, E here. Now number eight sentence is here, the farmer. Okay, so you have to match the farmer, sows wheat and rice, so you have to write D here. Clear? Number nine sentence, the number nine subject is here, grapes, you have to match the predicate part, grapes grow on vines. Clear? Yes, grapes. Go on, mice. Okay, number 10 sentence, bread. Bread is made of flour. Okay, so you have to write B here. Okay, student?